So I've made up the first sealed deck that I have from that first pool of cards that we opened up from the six booster packs. I decided to go with red and black for this one. The biggest problem that I noticed throughout each of the colors was there weren't a lot of big creatures, really. A decent amount of small ones, but really nothing too powerful, and even as far as the small creatures go, nothing was really overwhelming in creatures. So there's a lot more instant sorcery, basically just non-creature spells, than I'm used to including. I went with 16 lands. I have a Traveler's Amulet to help fetch any land that I may need. Of course, that brings it to your hand, not on the board, but that's still going to pull land out of your deck into your hand, so it's going to help out. Basically, what I had in mind was using the black removals. We've got two copies of Lethal Sting, two copies of Torment of Venom, one of Torment of Scarabs that'll stay on the board, an Hour of Glory that'll take out whatever I need. And then with red, we have a couple copies of Blur of Blades, a Firebrand Archer. There's only one in there, but with all the instant sorceries that I have in here, it's going to help sneak some damage through and then hopefully whittle the opponent down so that these bigger red creatures and Inferno Jet can finish the job to win the game. And then of course there's the Mirage Mirror we had that can copy an opponent's creature if we need to, in case they have something big, or if I have one of my larger creatures out in the field. It can do that, and actually what's pretty cool is that it can be an enchantment. I guess that's just till end of turn, so I don't think it would feed off of Torment of Scarabs. You could cast it during your untap, I suppose, as long as you have the mana available for it. But yeah, that's what I had in mind. I basically put the mana curve, it topped out around 4. I was hoping for more 3 mana cost spells, but it is what it is. We'll see if 4 will be good enough, and then it drops significantly up here, so that's why I went with only 16 lands. And the Sunset Pyramid I think is going to help out, since there's a lot of removal spells. I'm hoping the board will be clear and I can use this to kind of refill my hand and maybe search for something I need if that happens to be the case of the game. And as far as lands go, we've got two copies of Deserts, and that's going to hopefully come out before my Sand Strangler does, because by itself it's not that great of a card, but with the Desert it's a great card. You're putting out 3/3 and most likely taking out a creature your opponent has. So yeah, that's our first deck. Thanks for tuning in.